want to better understand this idea of a standard state that we pick when we calculate an equilibrium constant for a chemical reaction. So what we're going to look at is that what happens if we change the standard state. It's going to change our equilibrium constant. We'll show it doesn't change the equilibrium composition. So we'll look at the water gas shift reaction. And the first thing I want to do, and I'm looking at it for the case where I have gas phase water, and I want to calculate delta G of reaction at standard conditions. In this case, since it's all gases, 1 bar pressure, and we're doing this at 25 degrees C. So this corresponds to delta G of formation, standard condition, the product. So CO2 and delta G of formation of H2 minus delta G of formation of the reactants, CO and water. But keep in mind now it's important that this is gas phase, standard state for gas phase water. And so I'm going to look up these numbers and substitute them in. So a couple things to notice. For an element, delta G is 0. And I've calculated delta G is negative minus 28.6 kilojoules per mole. So now that I have delta G, I should be able to get the equilibrium constant at 25 degrees C for this reaction. And it's going to be exponential of minus delta G of reaction at standard conditions divided by the gas constant and the absolute temperature. So let's substitute in those numbers. So a couple things again to notice here. I've put the delta G value now in joules rather than kilojoules, so 28,600, and used appropriate units. This is dimensionless. And so equilibrium constants have no dimensions. They're ratios of activities. And so remember, this is equilibrium constant where the standard state is water in the gas phase, so 1 bar ideal gas. So we can use the equilibrium constant to calculate equilibrium compositions. And we're just going to look at it in terms of pressures. So I've written equilibrium constant in terms of activities. Products divided by reactants, and then stoichiometric coefficients are all one in this case. So the little hat is just to indicate that this is activity in a mixture. And the activity is a ratio of fugacity. So let's write this down for CO2. It's the fugacity of CO2 in this equilibrium mixture divided by pure component fugacity, in this case, the ideal gas, at standard conditions, 1 bar, and for the temperature, 25 degrees. And then we have similar terms for the other activities. And so the equilibrium constant now is written in terms of fugacities. And we can substitute in terms of pressures. So let's do that. So notice what I've done. Standard state, ideal gas, fugacity is equal to the pressure. That's 1 bar. I've also then assumed ideal gases for our system, just to make it easier to visualize. So I've substituted pressures, the partial pressures in equilibrium mixture, for the fugacity. So this term, for example, is the pressure of CO2 in the equilibrium mixture. Notice to keep units correct, this pressure must be in bar. Same for the other pressures, they must be expressed in units of bar. And so I have then the equilibrium constant in terms of partial pressures, and then I could use the normal extent of reaction type calculations for some starting conditions to figure out equilibrium partial pressures. Keep in mind, this was assuming water, standard state was a gas. So now let's look at if we made a different assumption that water at standard state was a liquid. So I'm going to rewrite the reaction and calculate delta G in that case. So I've written the reaction in terms of liquid. Delta G calculation looks the same, but now we have to keep in mind this is for liquid water as opposed to gaseous water. That's our standard state. So again, we can go to tables and look up the delta G's formations. Let me substitute in those values. So the calculation looks pretty similar. The only differences are indicated in purple. We have different delta G when it's liquid water rather than gas phase water, and therefore we have a different delta G for the reaction here. But we can calculate equilibrium constant the same way as before, and that's that the exponential of this new delta G of reaction over RT. So let's substitute in those values. So again, very much like calculation before, I've indicated in purple, since we have a different delta G, we end up with a different equilibrium constant, so I should probably call this K prime just to distinguish it. So we have a different equilibrium constant, still dimensionless, and it's different because we're using as our standard state water, a liquid phase. And so we want to see then how we get equilibrium pressures for this system. So let's substitute in, just as we did before, in terms of activities, and those in terms of fugacities. And again, I've indicated in purple what's different, that we have, instead of one bar here, since our standard state's liquid, we have to put the fugacity of liquid water at one bar and 25 degrees C, which is going to be its saturation pressure. We're assuming ideal gases, its saturation pressure at those conditions. And so this means when I substitute in the equilibrium constant in terms of pressure, so what I'm going to do is take this equation and rearrange it so we compare it to the other equation. And so it looks like this now. So pressure of water saturation conditions was in denominator, but in a denominator term in the denominator. So if I move it, it would be on the numerator on this side of the equation if I rearranged it, which puts it over here in the denominator. Now notice this is the equilibrium constant I calculated before, and that was 1.03 times 10 to the fifth, and it's dimensionless. This term here, this was 3.34 times 10 to the third, and now remember saturation pressure has to be in bar to cancel the writing this pressure in bar. So this number that we compare, the units will be consistent. And if I look up the saturation pressure at 25 degrees C, 0.317 bar, keep in mind the weighty units have to cancel. So this gives me now this ratio of pressures at equilibrium, 1.05 times 10 to the fifth. These are essentially the same number, and it's a function of how many significant figures I carry through in that exponential and the saturation pressure that I use in comparing and which conditions were used and what tables I pulled values from. If I do everything to enough significant figures carefully, these are the same number as we would expect. We do not change this equilibrium composition, the ratio of pressures, just because we pick a different standard state. But we clearly can have a different equilibrium constant as a result. And so this is just to help understand this idea of standard state and where the equilibrium constant comes from and how it does depend on which standard states we pick. But we have to be consistent. If we pick a different standard state in calculating delta G, we have to be consistent in putting that standard state into the fugacity standard state in the equilibrium calculation.